Being the chair of Caltrain this year. I want to welcome all of you and thank you for coming today. This is our third event where the public has a chance to view the trains, and we have increased in RSVPs for each subsequent event, so we are over 5,000 RSVPs today. I want to thank everyone for coming, and we have quite a notable list of speakers today. We've got Congresswoman Anna Eshoo here.
Oh, wow.
We've got Congressman Kevin Mullen.
Yeah.
All right, and apologies to everyone else. We're just going to do the single clap because this list is long for all the notables here today. State Senator Josh Becker. State Senator Dave Cortese, Assemblywoman Diane Pappin, Assemblymember Mark Herman, Assemblyman Alex Lee. We have our FTA Region 9 Administrator Ray Tallis, and we have San Mateo County Building and Construction Trades Council Business Manager Bart Pantoja, In addition, we have many people who are here today who won't be speaking, who have been partners on this project. We have JPB members, so that's Caltrain board members, Jeff G. and Rico Medina. We have San Mateo County Transit Board of Directors, Emily Beach and Norella Corzo. And we have the SamTrans Chair, Marina Fraser. We also are joined today by the Executive Director of the San Francisco County Transit Authority, Tilly Chang. And we are so excited to have you all here. We are also extremely excited that all major construction has been completed on the electrification project. And we are now entering the final phase. And I want to take this moment to thank all the employees who have dedicated countless hours to build this project. Can we give them a round of applause? I heard someone say 7 years, and I'm just going to correct you and say it was actually a vision of the agency for over 20 years ago to electrify Caltrain, and now it is a reality. Yeah, this is a celebration. You can clap as much as you want. And I also want to say we have three partner agencies for the Joint Powers Authority. We have the City and County of San Francisco. We've got Valley Transit Authority in Santa Clara County. And I want to give a special shout out to San Mateo County and SamTrans, because in addition to being a partner agency, they have been the managing agency since pretty much the beginning of Caltrain. And all the hard work and dedication that SamTrans employees put in to Caltrain as a part of their job, they just deserve another round of applause. So today, as we look forward to electrifying Caltrain and electric service starting this fall, we are also commemorating 160 years of passenger service on the line, all on National Train Day. That's today. Yeah. So you are all here, and all of you know that Caltrain and all rail service has played an integral part of the growth in the Bay Area, and we are excited for what the future holds in our region. With our transition to an electric railroad, Caltrain will not only be faster and provide more service to our riders, it will also be cleaner and more sustainable for the communities we serve. We hope you enjoy the new trains today and continue to take public transit. Come join us in the fall as we bring these electric trains into service in September. And with that, I would like to call up Congresswoman Anna Eshoo, who has been a huge supporter of Caltrain over the years.
Happy retirement.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Excited.
This is really an auspicious occasion. We're celebrating the 160th anniversary of Caltrain. 160 years ago, there was a young president from Illinois that had a vision. His name was Abraham Lincoln, and he saw to it that this railroad would be created. It took the vision of another young president from Illinois, Barack Obama. He too had a vision that the investment was a worthy one. And so we are on the cusp of these trains running electrified. As it was said, this has been the vision for a long, long time. You all know that this has not been an easy journey to get here. It's been more than 10 years since I led the effort for a blended system to make Caltrain our own high-speed rail system for the peninsula. We worked very hard to bring together the businesses, labor, local governments, the agencies, the writers, and the environmental community together in support of that vision. I'm so proud to have secured over $1 billion in federal funding for Caltrain. And this was despite when the Trump administration came in, their opposition and the opposition of members of Congress that lacked a vision, to put it mildly. An electrified Caltrain will be the modern, world-class transportation system that our innovative region deserves, with faster, quieter, cleaner trains that will improve air quality and significantly reduce greenhouse gas emissions, an investment that will pay dividends for generations to come. So today, we can all say that in our day and in our time, there was leadership, there was a vision, all through tenacity, that brought us to this moment. I want to thank everyone that has been a key stakeholder in this. It's taken all of us to bring us to this day. So I thank you. And speaking of leadership and vision, I'm happy to recognize the gentleman from San Mateo County, Kevin Mullen, my buddy in the Congress. I couldn't ask for a better one. Thank you for sending it to us. Kevin?
Is she the best?
Yeah!
For three decades, she's been the best. We are so grateful to you, Anna, for your service to our county and our region, and no bigger champion for this railroad than the woman on my right. So thank you so much, Anna, for the introduction. Wonderful to be here to celebrate another historic milestone in the electrification of Caltrain. As a longtime supporter of electrification, I was proud to author legislation in 2016 to ensure state funds were available for Caltrain. This success, however, this model transit project, is the ultimate team win. Now, as a member of Congress, along with Anna's partnership and leadership, I pledge to continue to pursue funding opportunities that will support public transportation infrastructure in the 15th Congressional District, including money for grade separations, which will make this entire system work. So we are getting closer every day to Caltrain's launching of the first electrified commuter rail service in California. This will be a historic accomplishment for the future of sustainable transportation in our state. And while electrified service will allow Caltrain to provide increased frequency and capacity for riders, of equal importance is the elimination of greenhouse gas emissions produced by retiring those diesel engines. This is a signature project for the nation, the state, and especially important to my constituents in the district, many of whom rely on Caltrain to get to work, school, and special events like Giants games. Last night I was on the train with my wife and two boys. They lost, unfortunately, but we'll ignore that. Caltrain is and will continue to be the spine that supports our innovation economy. And I fully expect that President Biden and Secretary of Transportation Buttigieg will be pointing to this project as a model for the future of this country and its transportation infrastructure. And by the way, we will never let a geomagnetic solar storm shut down this road. Congratulations on this next step, and I look forward to riding a fully electrified Caltrain soon. And it is now, with that, my pleasure to introduce San Mateo County's representative in the California State Senate and the new chair of the Bay Area Caucus, State Senator Josh Becker.
Thank you. I'm going to keep this brief. In my role as state senate, sometimes I get to start things that won't come to fruition until 10, 20 years down the road. And sometimes I get to have the baton in that final leg. And just being here, I'm just so grateful for everyone who served before me including my predecessor, Jerry Hill, and all the wonderful officials we've had serving on Caltrain and SamTrans, and especially our Congresswoman Anna Eshoo, who fought so hard for the money to make this day possible. I'll just say two things. One, this is everything I love. Electrification, as we electrify transportation here with our both our train system and now also with our passenger rail and our passenger vehicles and now with heavy duty trucks. So this electrification and also innovation, right? We're doing this. This is going to be faster. This is going to be quieter, and this is just going to be something that pays dividends up and down my district for years and years to come. The last thing I'll say is, as chair of the Bay Area Caucus, as the Congressman mentioned, we are 27 legislators across the Bay Area, many of whom are here today, and we are always thinking about how can we enhance the quality of life across the Bay Area. Of course, we think about housing and affordability and homelessness, but right now, transportation is very much on our minds. How do we save transportation in the Bay Area? How do we secure it for generations going forward? And days like this and celebrations like this will help us do this as people see the future of transportation in the Bay Area. Thank you very much. And since I don't have my notes, I'm not sure who I'm introducing. So I will bring up my fellow senator and now our chair of transportation in the state legislature, Dave Cortese.
Good morning. I have to look at my watch. I'm very, very happy to be here, not only as the Senate Transportation Chair for the state of California, but as somebody who was elected to the San Jose City Council 24 years ago, and at that time appointed to the VTA board by then Mayor Ron Gonzalez, and told before I took that position what a priority the electrification of Caltrain was. And you know, I otherwise would have, honestly, very candidly, I would have arrived at my first meeting that looked at the preferred investment strategy with all those things on it, the BART extension, bus rapid transit and light rail in the east side of my district, and I probably would have looked at electrification and just said, what's that? Not that we don't know what it means, but why is it important? And it's always been an important piece of Santa Clara County's agenda in terms of transportation and transportation investment. And it's so great seeing our congressional representatives here and being here with my colleagues, State Senator Josh Becker and the rest of you. When Congresswoman Eshoo came up here to speak, the next thought I had was my first trip to Washington as chair of the Metropolitan Transportation Commission, walking into her office, sitting down around the coffee table, and before we could even get comfortable, the first words out of her mouth, now you're going to take care of Caltrain, right? You're going to take care of electrification. You always knew what the agenda was with her, right? And it takes that kind of leadership and the continued leadership, I think, of elected officials who are in a position to hold the purse strings and to make these kinds of decisions. It's wonderful to have been around this long because, as Senator Becker was alluding to, you get to see eventually the fruition of all this work through ups and downs and great recessions and problems like we're having temporarily in the state of California right now getting in the way. But congratulations to Caltrain and everybody involved for getting this project. This is a landmark project. Words can't even really put in the right descriptors to describe what this really means for California, not just for this region, and for leading the nation in terms of how things should be done. So thank you very much for the opportunity to be here. I want to introduce another colleague in the legislature. I walked up to her today and said, it's great to be on your turf. A family friend as well, Assembly Member Diane Pappin.
Well, good morning and welcome to the 21st AD. I'm so glad to be here. So Caltrain comes through the district that I represent in Sacramento. We've got about 30 miles of it that comes through our district, so it's tremendously important to this district. And I kind of see this as the third act of Caltrain. We started with steam, then we went to diesel, and now we've got electrification. And this doesn't happen by accident, as we've heard from many of the speakers here. There's been a tremendous commitment from this community to keeping Caltrain alive. You know, in the 70s, when another member of my family served in the state legislature, the man that sired me, Southern Pacific came along, and they were kind of at the moment. Southern Pacific was of the mind that, well, you know, maybe you don't need a commuter rail up and down the peninsula. And the state had to step in for a while, hence the name Caltrain. Then the community stepped in, and they did what they needed to do to keep this commuter train alive. This is the third act. Welcome to it, folks. We couldn't be more excited to have it. This means green. Or more green, it means vitality. And as soon as we get the grade steps, from a lot of dollars from the federal government, did I just say that? Oh yes, I did. As soon as we get the grade steps, we'll even be farther along. So I'm very pleased to be here today to commemorate getting underway with electrification. It hasn't been easy, as we all know. It is a cobbling together of funds, but we made it, and we're here to the third act. And I'm so honored to have brought a certificate of recognition for Caltrain and all of its accomplishments. And it's signed by all of my colleagues from the legislature that are a part of the delegation that Caltrain runs through. And away we go with public transportation. Thank you so much. Without further ado, I'm turning it over to Berman. Come on up.
Thank you, Assemblymember Pappin, and good morning, everyone. My name is Mark Berman, and I represent the 23rd Assembly District in the California State Assembly, just to the south and also to the west of here. And whether it's my wife, who commuted on Caltrain to work for years, or myself, who commuted on Caltrain to Giants games for decades, so many of my constituents have been the beneficiary of Caltrain, and so many of my constituents are excited for this Stage 3 that we're entering into. And as a member of the Assembly Transportation Committee, I'm really excited to tour these new trains and see the innovative strides that Caltrain has made in electrifying its fleet. Back in July of 2017, I was just a baby Assembly member, just gotten elected, and I was here for the groundbreaking of this project with Congressman Eshoo, then Assembly Member Mullen, and I actually still have the big golden shovel from that groundbreaking that we show off in the lobby of my district office in Palo Alto. It's impressive and really exciting to see the progress that's been made since then. And our drive towards improving our public transit and our commitment to a more sustainable future have remained consistent amongst transit agencies, all of the elected officials, both past and present, who have represented the Caltrain corridor, and the community at large who we see here today. Today represents an incredible opportunity for the community to experience firsthand the modernized, more sustainable trains that will soon be serving our region. I'm also thrilled to be joining everyone today as we celebrate another significant milestone in our region's transportation history, the 160th anniversary, as we heard before, of Caltrain's passenger rail service. For over a century and a half, Caltrain, and I loved hearing how it was Lincoln who was the president back then. That's like amazing history when you think about it. But for over a century and a half, Caltrain has been connecting communities, facilitating commerce, and providing a vital link for commuters. So thank you to Caltrain. Thank you to all of Caltrain's staff who have worked so hard on this important project. And enjoy the trains and the rest of today's festivities. And next, it's an honor to introduce my colleague, Assemblymember Alex Lee.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Alex Lee. I have the great honor of representing the 24th Assembly District in Alameda and Santa Clara counties, and I like trains. And if you're here today, too, I bet you like trains as well. I'll keep it short because I really do want to get out there and check out the train myself as well. But for the past 4 or 5 years, when Caltrain gave me the model for what we're seeing today, which was very surreal to see it very faithfully represented in person, I have proudly displayed the model train in my office and shamelessly enough played with it a couple times, but I've actually had it in my office because this is, of course, the future of transportation in America and in our region, but we must remember that we are catching up with the rest of the world. In Europe and in Asia, which we have learned a lot from, we are catching up to them. And if we want to be the center of innovation for the world, we must be competitive with our global means of transportation and continue to do so. That's why I'm very proud in this legislative session to be authoring a CEQA streamlining bill for train electrification, which, to my great surprise, has been on consent, so thank you to my colleagues. But if we had the common sense streamlining years ago, Caltrain would have saved thousands of dollars, if not millions of dollars, unfortunately, but at least because now other agencies in California have learned from your success and tribulations, they're going to go forward electrifying different corridors, like the Capitol Corridor and other parts of Southern California as well. So we want to make sure that we are continued momentum for train electrification and high-speed rail across California. So I want to thank Caltrain and thank all the local, state, and federal partners for making this happen, and I really appreciate being invited here today. Thank you. And I think I have the great honor of bringing up our FTA Region 9 Administrator, Ray Tellis. Thank you.
Service that is going to follow in less than a couple of months to come. So certainly congratulations also on the 160th anniversary, both the Madam Chair as well as you, Michelle, in leading this agency at this point when it's so transformative. On behalf of the Federal Transit Administration, we are certainly excited. I bring congratulations from Secretary Pete. He was mentioned along with President Biden, who has engaged and through your congressional representatives brought to transit through the bipartisan infrastructure law, the most history for transit, the most money, most funding for transit in the history of transit. And I think that deserves a round of applause. So judging from the number of people here that are going to be touring the trains, this is an exciting time, certainly a better experience. Cleaner trains, faster trains, addressing the carbon footprint, smoother ride, and getting to where this region needs us to get that connectivity. I think Caltrain is very engaged now, taking the rail system further south in terms of electrification, but also taking it into the Salesforce Transit Center. I think that's remarkable, right? And as we have the BART project come through San Jose and into Santa Clara and tie with Caltrain, we'll have that ring around the bay, which is going to be just remarkable. Tilly, I know you're very excited about that. So as we go through this process, and we have provided significant funding, but it is certainly funding that your congressional representatives have brought you, that the president has afforded us. We are privileged as the Federal Transit Administration to administer that funds. We have walked in providing the oversight for this project from its inception, and we are just remarkably pleased at what we are going to see in the couple of weeks to come. I look forward to coming back in late August or in September for two occasions, one for a occasion with the dignitaries and a soft launch, and then finally full service in September as Caltrain runs every one of these trains through this corridor to San Francisco, further south a little, and then in the days to come all the way through, ringing the bay. Congratulations to everyone. I see some of your team members. I saw Sherry. You have worked diligently, pressing on. Nothing swayed you. There were challenges along the way, but you did it. You're here. You can't relax yet because you have to go a little further, but congratulations. And with that, it's my pleasure to welcome up Bart Pantoja, who is certainly instrumental in all of the labor and everything else that contributes to successful projects like this. Thank you again.
Thank you for the introduction. So I'm gonna talk about apprenticeship a bit. So it takes about 3 to 5 years to be, as an apprentice, to become a journey person. We consider it the other 4-year degree when it comes to building a career. So this project broke ground in 2017, which means that there are journey status workers that established their careers on this project and are working in their field today because of this project. I understand it's gonna, yes, thank you. But don't thank me, I thank Caltrain and all the stakeholders. So I understand this has been a long journey to see the completion of an idea to what we see here, you know, in this train and this electrified rail. The other thing that was built besides this electrified rail and this amazing train behind me is livelihoods were built, careers were built, lives were changed because of projects like this, because of partnerships between labor, management, and our public servants, many of our stakeholders here. So on behalf of the 20 trade union affiliates that I represent, I want to say thank you to all of you. Thank you for that partnership. And I look forward to working together on future projects, much like this here with Caltrain and all over our county. And that's pretty much all I got. So, where's my guy? He got up. There he is. So, without further ado, Don Mr. Fabulous Cecil from Samsita.
So, last means fast. It's a pleasure to represent the San Mateo County Economic Development Association. We partner with our friends at the Bay Area Council, Silicon Valley Leadership Group, and the folks here in the front row, elected officials, our friends in the transit advocate community, environmental community, BART, our good friends in labor, building trades. And I just want to say, how spectacular does that train look? There it is. So, on behalf of the business community, major employers, the businesses that need people to ride this train in downtown San Carlos and all along the railway, we're so thankful for this. So thankful for everyone coming together to make this happen. And have a great day. Thank you.
Many thanks to our speakers. We do want to have you up for a photo. And so I know the crowds have already started getting on the train, but we want to make sure to celebrate you here right now. So if you could join me up on the stage, we would appreciate that. Thank you so much for being here. And thank you for all the folks that are already checking out the train.
Guys, hard work. So we broke ground in 2017.
Thank you.
Wait that long.
Alrighty.
September. How you doing? You're from Statler.
Yes,
how you doing?
Good.
I visited the plant in Salt Lake. That was amazing.
Oh, very nice. Yes.
On my way to Yellowstone. I had a good time.
I like it there.
Yeah.
I like our building.
Yeah, it's fantastic. Yeah. It was 2019. They had just opened it up, and they just started manufacturing.
Yeah. Open house. Very nice.
Yeah. Well, I had a special permission to come over there, and they had a model of the BART car. You know, the e-BART car there in the lobby.
Yeah, that's nice.
Hi, folks.
You can move
down. Yep, yep.
Rush. Where we go?
So they gotta have enough trains to start the service, or is it gonna be hybrid operations? Do you know in September?
We'll have enough trains to run fully electric between San Francisco and San Jose
by the fall.
Exactly.
Oh, okay. Because I thought maybe they still have quite a few more KISS trains coming in from Salt Lake.
They're still getting delivered, but we'll have them all burned in and ready to go.
Oh, right.
Service. We're working hard for it.
So what, September, October, or what?
September, end of September.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, you heard them. I said the end of September. 100%. All the schedule is 100% electric. Looks like they're ambitious. At the end of September, they're going to have all of the trains ready to go, huh?
Yeah.
Is that what they're saying?
That's what
they're
going.
Wow. Too many months away. I feel like I'm at a airport jetway.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Transfer to my phone.